Now, researchers from Monash University have discovered a life-changing pill that could provide long-term relief from allergic reactions, hay fever and even thunderstorm asthma. To tell us all about it, it's a big hello and good morning to Dr. Andrew Rochford. It's nice to see you, Doc.
Morning, guys.
So tell us about this tablet and how long until it's available.
Yeah, so this tablet has been developed basically in really simple terms. It's a tablet that is infused with like tiny doses of pollens or allergens. And basically it's through an exposure type therapy where they retrain the immune system of the allergy sufferer so that they don't have severe reactions to allergies when they are exposed to that allergen in the future. You know, it's taken under the tongue for 4 months. And basically the idea is over that period of time, it retrains the immune system to obviously recognize the allergen, not respond in the way that it has previously, where there's this overwhelming allergic response, and then ultimately reduce that risk of severe, you know, asthma attacks, like, you know, thunderstorm asthma, which is ultimately when, you know, we see a thunderstorm with huge high pollen levels, and people can have severe asthma related to that. So that's the idea here. It's not a new idea. You know, for a while now, we've seen that small micro doses of allergens can help retrain an immune system. This is just another delivery form. Unfortunately, doesn't work for everybody. It works for some people, but not everybody. And so ultimately, you will see this in certain places. People, you know, that are at high risk may potentially see benefit from this in the future.
Wow. And there's been a breakthrough in other medical news, which hopefully is for everyone, when it comes to the Alzheimer's drug. It's been found to slow mental decline.
Yeah, for a very long time, obviously lots, billions of dollars going into research to try to see whether we can find a cure for Alzheimer's and dementia. Obviously, as we age, we're seeing more and more of the population suffering from this devastating disease. The exciting thing about this drug, lecanemab, is that it has shown two things. One, it has shown that there is a decline in the buildup of the toxic proteins called amyloid that are, you know, hallmark of the buildup in the brain that causes the decline. But the other thing, they've seen clinical benefit, which means they've seen a significant reduction in the amount of decline in the people given this drug. Over an 18-month period, those that received this medication had 27% less decline in their mental function, and that's orientation, memory, problem solving, than those that were given the placebo. This is, again, it's exciting because almost in a generation, we haven't seen a drug that's had that kind of impact on cognitive decline. So moving to a point now where hopefully going to start getting market approval in early next year. And again, hopefully more research moving to one day, you know, finding that cure.
Great.
Hope so. It's such a terrible and cruel disease. Let's talk exercise, Doc. We've got the world's fittest woman coming up on the show shortly. But a new study has found that how fast you walk is just as important as how many steps you take when it comes to healthy ageing.
Yeah, absolutely. So for a very long time, there's been that, you know, the 10,000 steps a day hallmark that's been put out there. And every time we, you know, see more research, it's either it's the right number, it's the wrong number. This study has come out and said it's actually pretty close to the sweet spot if you want to get the best benefits. So about 9,800 steps they found in this study was the sweet spot. But the interesting thing was that it's actually also can be out done by the pace. So it's actually not just the number of steps, but you can actually get the benefit also if you don't have the time for 10,000 if you increase your pace. So the idea of power walking, short bursts, can also see that impact on your health, reduction in dementia risk, improvements in cardiovascular health, reduction in other chronic diseases. But the other interesting thing they found in this study is that there is no minimum benefit. That's not great for your hips if you do it like that.
You want to get that done quicker before anyone sees you.
That is aggressive power walking, but, you know, only trained professionals like those guys can do that. But, yeah, ultimately, there's actually no minimum. So no matter where you start, if you increase, you will see a benefit in your health. So I think for a lot of people, that whole idea of getting to 9,800 or 10,000 steps is a big mountain to climb. Mm-hmm. All I would say is this research has said no matter where you're starting today, if you do more steps than you did yesterday, you are benefiting your health. And if you work on that theory, you know, every day you'll be doing something for your aging and your health.
That's slow and steady wins the race. Doc, you're back a bit later to answer some questions, so we'll see you then.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Doc.
All right. And if you do have a problem for Doc, pop on our socials or email us at studio10@network10.com.au and we'll put them to Doc, who'll answer them soon.